Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. You can configure and bootstrap Hibernate in multiple different ways. And today I want to show you how to use its native bootstrapping API. This API is very flexible, which makes it more complicated to use, but also more powerful than the JPA bootstrapping API. Before you can start the bootstrapping process, you need to add the required dependencies to your class path. I'm using Hibernate 5.2.10 in this video, and the Hibernate core jar file is the only required Hibernate dependency. And it includes the JPA jar file as a transitive dependency. You also need to add a database-specific JDBC driver to the class path of your application. Please check your database documentation for more information. As soon as you've added the required dependencies, you can implement the bootstrapping process. You need to create a standard service registry, build a metadata object, and use it to instantiate a session factory. Hibernate uses two service registries, the bootstrap service registry and the standard service registry. The default standard service registry provides a good solution for most applications, and I therefore skipped the programmatic definition of it in this video. The standard service registry requires some configuration. I do that in this example with the hibernate.cfg.xml file. It makes the implementation easy and allows you to change the configuration without changing the source code. Hibernate loads the configuration file automatically from the class path when you call the configure method on the standard service registry builder. You can then adapt the configuration programmatically before you call the build method to get a service registry. Here you can see an example of a hibernate.cfg.xml configuration file. Your configuration might differ if you use a different database or a connection pool. In this example, I used the PostgreSQL dialect and connect to a PostgreSQL database on localhost. I also tell Hibernate to generate the database tables based on the entity mappings. But please, don't do that in production. You should always use an SQL script to create a reviewed, optimized, and tested database schema. Okay, we instantiated a configured service registry. Now you need to create a metadata representation of your domain model. You can do that based on the configuration files hbm.xml and orm.xml, or on annotated entity classes. Here I use annotated classes. I first use the service registry to instantiate a new metadata sources object. Then I add my annotated entity classes and call the build metadata to create the metadata representation. After that is done, I call the build session factory method on the metadata object to instantiate a session factory. And that's all you need to do to create a basic Hibernate setup with its native API. You can now use the session factory to open a new session and use it to read or persist your entities. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!